Hey guys, this is Gurpreet. Welcome to Cloud eTech. How are you doing today? Hope everybody's doing well. So today, this is a video of the first practical video on the channel. Today, we're going to talk about how Intune portal looks like, how it works, how we can navigate through the different Intune options available on the Intune portal. So let's quickly jump in. This is going to be a short video. So I'm just going to log into portal.azure.com. We have two ways to go to Intune. We can log in through portal.azure.com or devicemanagement.microsoft.com. So the portal.azure.com will give you the whole Azure page, and the devicemanagement.microsoft.com will give you the Intune page itself. So let's quickly log in and see how it looks like. I'm just going to log in. All right, so once you log into portal.azure.com, then you have a page similar like this. You have all the services which are there. So we click on more services, then we get more options available. But at the moment, I just logged in and I can see Intune here. So just click on Intune. So once we click on Intune, these are the first page you get into. You get all the things like overview, quick start, the device enrollment. We're going to go in depth in all the options which are available for Intune. And in the top, you see we have a different options altogether here. Let me just click that once. It'll give us a new page. And here it is. So now it is the page which is dedicated for Intune. Now the URL is devicemanagement.microsoft.com. So basically, we have different teams in the company, in the organization. So they don't want you to log in if you are an MDM guy, if they don't want you to log into the complete Azure portal. And it's very simple. They can give you a URL and you can have your own ID and you log in and you end up with this page. Okay. So the dashboard we talk about, so they will give you all the devices which are enrolled. What is the status of a device enrollment, if there's any enrollment in the past, if was there any failure in the enrollment. They can tell you if all the applications were installed, if you published any recently. Device compliance, if there's any compliance issue, if we have any device configuration issues which are there. So whenever you log in the first time in the morning, there'll be some of the things which are available on the dashboard and you'll be able to fix that. So check about the devices. So here are the devices. We can see if we click on all devices. So let's say, for example, we have some Windows devices on my name. I was doing testing. In the coming videos, we'll talk about how the Windows enrollment works and things like that. We have option to monitor. And if you click on monitor, we will see what all compliance, if you have non-compliant devices. We have device with compliance issues, settings which have gone, policies which has gone, and enrollment updates. So we can monitor almost every aspect of a device if we sent any configuration policies through there. Let's just go back. Now we can also search a device using the platform. For example, if they are Windows, and we can just see Windows devices, configuration. So we can send the PowerShell scripts. The security baseline, if you talk about security baseline, we have predefined baselines which we can just click and send. So it's one click and we can just send it. So we can just create a profile here and send it. And let's talk about enroll devices. So here we have settings for different enrollments. So this is the first thing you set up when you set up the Intune as the MDM authority. So once you have a brand new Azure portal, after configuring the Azure AD team configures the Azure AD for you, the first thing you have to do is get the Intune as set as your MDM authority. So once you do that, the first thing you have to set is how enrollment works. So for example, we have different enrollment settings for Windows, like this is for Windows Autopilot. We'll talk about the Autopilot as well in the coming videos. Then the Apple enrollment. For Apple, we specifically have to update a push notification service. I will make a short video for this, how it works. And this is updated yearly. It's very important. Once you create the Apple APNS certificate, the APNS certificate has to be renewed after 1 year with the same email ID it was first created. If it's not done, all the Apple devices will be disconnected from the MDM console. And the uploading of this device is pretty simple, but you have to do this and you don't have to miss the date. If you do so, it's gonna be a trouble. Then we have the Android enrollment, how it works. We have different profiles now with MDM, with personal device, work profile, corporate owned, fully corporate owned devices, which are personal and corporate owned both. So we have different settings. We can also inculcate manage Google Pay service to send the automatic applications. And then we have enrollment restrictions. So in this, there are different categories how we can restrict and limit the restriction, limit the device enrollment. For example, if you don't want a particular type of platform to be out of the enrollment stuff, we can do that. Or we can upload a new list, upload a list with the serial numbers. The only these are the devices which can enroll to Intune. We can set that using applications, using versions of different OS. We can stop the enrollment and limit the number of devices. For example, at the moment it is set by default as 5 devices per user, so they can be either 3 or 2. It depends on the organization. Then we have the corporate device identifiers. Basically, here we add the devices which are owned by the corporation, and they give you the device. Only that device will be enrolled. Other than that, you cannot enroll any device in the Intune MDM. Then we have the device enrollment managers. Here we manually, an admin will add the devices for you, and you just get the device, and once you have the device, you just follow the steps and the device will be enrolled. So this was enrollment. In the device itself, we have different categories. We can set the compliance policy, the conditional access. This is to access applications. We will have a whole new video for this because it's not just a small topic to cover, the conditional access. We can set the configuration policies, and these are things which can be done using the device tab. And let's quickly go to the applications. So here in Intune, we have different enrollment options. For example, we have devices which are MDM or devices which are MAM. So the MAM devices, you don't need to enroll the device. It is just the applications which are secured and covered in this MDM solution. So we have different options for that. We can send applications by a platform, which is Windows, iOS, Mac, and Android. Then we can set the app protection policies. So here, let's open one policy just to see how it works. So let's just say test and app protection number one, for example. Let's click on next. So now we can see what all options we can set here. So it says target to app on all devices, so it should be yes. Public app, we can select a public app or we can select custom app. Let's go ahead and select public applications. So let's say if somebody has installed Teams. So Teams is publicly available on iOS, and somebody has installed Teams, and the company wants, the admin wants the Teams to be managed. So we will select Teams and we'll click on next. So now the Teams will be checked as a managed device, even though the device is not enrolled. But whenever the Teams is downloaded using, and it's signed in using your company ID, then this policy will follow. So now we can set what all things we can be done. Can the team send the data to other applications? We can have policy manage apps, or maybe OS sharing, or we can have none. So let's keep it in policy manage apps. So can the device save copy? We can allow it or we can block it, so it will not be able to save the files from Teams to your device. And receive data from other apps, so it should be policy managed. Let's say it is policy managed here. And restrict cut copy paste, so we can block it. So once the device is on the Teams application, the cut copy paste or maybe a screenshot will be blocked from here. There are many options too. So we'll also have a detailed session for application management. So this is just to give you an overview how it works. I'm just quickly gonna go back and talk about endpoint security. So here we can set the security baseline for the devices which are enrolled, and These primarily are Android, iOS, and Windows. And we can set the compliance policy and conditional access to. The other two things here are users and groups. When we click on that, it'll take us to the Azure AD page where we can see and reset the password for a user and things like that. And what all groups are there. So if we have any group, we can just go ahead and add the user to the group or remove it. And things which are associated with MDM groups will be populated here. So this is pretty much the latest version of the Intune portal. And this is how it looks. It's a little different from the one which I started working on back in 2017. It's pretty much different now. And I think they have included a lot of features which are now useful, which are now doing great, which are more than any other MDM available in the market. So the next comparator, I think not the next, maybe the closest comparator to Intune is Workspace ONE. In Workspace ONE, they have a lot of features. So in the coming videos, we're going to talk about how Workspace ONE is similar to Intune, or maybe in some cases good from Intune as well. And we'll keep on putting this in the videos, and you'll see more and more videos in the practical as well. So in the coming videos, what I'm trying to do is that first give you some brief in terms of documentation and things like that. And once that is done, then we'll do a practical for that. So the purpose for this practical was, in the coming videos, I'm going to talk about in depth of all the features which are available in Intune. So once you have seen that, so that you'll be able to, you know, connect dots. And I would also recommend you to get a trial from Azure, portal.azure.com. They'll give you a trial for 30 days for $200. You just have to spend 1 rupee, that's in India, and $1 maybe in US, to just enroll, just get a trial version, and after that, close that account or maybe convert it to pay as you go. It all depends on you. In the coming videos, we will need the console for other things, how to enroll devices. In the coming video, it'll follow. Hope this video is good for you. If you need anything else apart from the video or documentation, as I mentioned in the previous videos as well, do let me know. I'll be happy to share documents and links provided by Microsoft. We'll learn along and we'll go do testing. We'll try to show you how to enroll devices, how to set policies, and in the coming videos, that will happen. So stay tuned. Thank you for your time. Have a nice day.